Oh, they're at it again. The supermarkets are dangling specials and deals in front of you like you're a seal. Problem is, sometimes they're advertising fresh snapper, but in reality, it's wads of rotting pilchards. But still, we gobble it up.
Come on down and chump some of this.
Last year, Consumer asked you and I to send in examples of dodgy deals. After 5 months, they'd received over 300 shonky specials. In the last 2 months, 160 complaints. Some of them included questionable multi-buy deals. Like this deal, 4 packets of rice crackers for $5. But originally, a single packet cost $1.09. That means the bundle actually costs you 64 cents more. Absolutely crackers. Consumers' campaign to collect clangers finishes this month. But supermarkets aren't the only ones hosing us with deals and promos and specials. Retailers have all sorts of tricks, including yucky gender-based pricing. According to Price Spy, this 100ml bottle of Calvin Klein Eternity is marketed toward women and goes for $79. The exact same product for men can be bought for $45. So, what's the best way to avoid all these scammy specials? Joining us now is Gemma Rasmussen from Consumer New Zealand. Gemma, nearly 500 dodgy specials there. Were you surprised by that number at all?
I was a little bit surprised and I was disappointed. You'd really hope that when people are going to the supermarkets, they can trust the pricing that they're seeing on the shelves, particularly when you're trying to buy essential everyday items. So it was pretty disappointing to see that the number was that high.
Yeah, we just heard how they can get you with the old multi-buy trick. Can you give us some other ways retailers can try and get more cash out of you?
Yeah, so some of the common complaints that we were seeing was a special that wasn't so special. So you would look under the special tag and the price, the original price, would be exactly the same. So you're not actually saving any money. And then the other thing that we were seeing was a shelf price displayed, but then people would get to the checkout and they'd actually find that the price that they were being charged was a lot higher.
Oh.
Is this just one offender or is this widespread across all supermarkets and actually other retailers?
So this is across Countdown, New World and Pack and Save.
Wow.
And what we were really seeing was this seems to be a supermarket issue with the duopoly. We don't know of any other retailers in New Zealand that seem to be having such a problem with their pricing. And we did find that Countdown, they had slightly more pricing errors that seemed to be a bit more of an issue. But it does seem to be something that's sitting with the supermarkets.
I'm really shocked by this. So I completely understand a mislabeling mistake. It happens. But this seems to be deliberately screwing people out of 20 cents here, a dollar there. Are there any consequences for this?
So what I think this potentially is a lack of innovation from the supermarkets into their pricing structures. Obviously, they've got hundreds of thousands of items that are going on their shelves, and you might expect a small margin of error. But given the excess profits that were reported on after that Commerce Commission study, they really should be putting in the investment to make sure that people are getting the prices that they deserve. And no one should have to go and individually photograph every item on the shelf and be cross-checking that. Like, no one's got the time for that. So, we would be expecting more. It is potentially a breach of the Fair Trading Act. So what we will be doing with all the amazing submissions that New Zealanders have sent to us is escalating this to the Commerce Commission for investigation.
Until supermarkets get their acts together, what's your advice to the rest of us?
If you have the time and the ability, you know, look under that special sticker. Maybe just be aware of what you're seeing on the shelf. And if anything looks a little bit odd when you're putting it through the checkout, don't be afraid to cross-check that. And also don't be afraid to talk to the people at the supermarket. Obviously, it's not their fault if there's been a pricing error, so don't abuse anyone. But you know, whether it's 20 cents or $2, you should be asking for a refund. You shouldn't be paying more.
Well, Gemma, thank you for following up on all of these and thanks for your time tonight.
Thanks for having me.
Kia ora, welcome to the project on Tuesday. Look, Mark Richardson's with us here tonight, ladies and gentlemen. Going to solve this one for us, Mark.
Well, just listening there, this isn't skullduggery. this sounds like it's just error from the supermarket. So I've discovered over the years that the best way to get performance out of people is to put them under extreme pressure. So how about we do this? We make it law that if you can prove when you're at the checkout that you have been overcharged for your trolley of goods, you get it free.
Oh, yeah, Simon.
Put the heat on them. Put the heat on them to get it right.
And I know what you're saying, it's not skullduggery, it's just error. But when supermarkets are making these enormous profits, if they're not investing that into streamlining their pricing and parts of their business that aren't working, then what are they doing?
Also, when I make an error by walking out of the supermarket without paying, suddenly I'm the bad guy, right? Let me get away with that.
Good advice, by the way, to check the prices. Lots of people don't have time to do that. And actually, there are heaps of reasons why you might not want to check the prices. Shame, embarrassment, not wanting to look like a Karen. I reckon, you know, probably the people who can least afford to lose money in this way are also the least likely to spend time.
Just when Karens were getting out of this whole thing.
I can tell you what they are doing with their profits. They're buying larger boats and beach houses. So how about if you get overcharged, you get a ride on the boat?
Yeah, perfect.